Here's another ecologically based one. So many resources have been spent on trying to get to the moon and now trying to get to Mars. What are your thoughts on us using some of these resources, more of these resources, towards solving problems on Earth instead?
I think we can do both. First of all, no one is saying that we should bankrupt the Earth to form this super colony on Mars. That's for science fiction. Yeah. I had a long conversation with Carl Sagan. Carl Sagan, of course, believed in the environment. He was the one who talked about nuclear winter. And he said all he wants is an insurance policy. He's not talking about creating another moon base or Mars base, another branch of humanity. He simply wants an insurance policy because he's seen what happens when meteors and asteroids hit the Earth. It's not pleasant. And look what happened to the dinosaurs. You know, the dinosaurs aren't here today to talk about it. And so his attitude was an insurance policy. Now, because prices are dropping like a rock, it becomes feasible. Now, to put anything in orbit, to put this in orbit around the planet Earth, costs about $10,000. $10,000 to put a pound of anything in orbit. Now we want to drive that down to $1,000 a pound. Now, $10,000 a pound is your weight in gold. Think of your body made out of solid gold. And that's what it costs just to put you in orbit around the planet Earth. That's why Virgin Atlantic is charging $250,000 to get a seat on a rocket that'll take you 70 miles straight up and back down again. Elon Musk wants to go to Mars and the moon. Forget just going up and down, right? For about the same price, because prices are dropping. We have to get used to that fact. So I don't think we should pit that against what's happening on the Earth. We don't want to bankrupt the Earth, but we want an insurance policy. Plus, what came out of this space program for consumers? The microchip, in some sense, came out of this space program. So the space program literally paid for itself. I still remember LBJ, President Johnson, was criticized heavily for the weather satellite called Tyros, the world's first weather satellite. People said, a weather satellite? All you have to do is lick your thumb, point it up, and you know the weather. You don't need this billion-dollar weather satellite in orbit. So LBJ got criticized very heavily. Then just before a press conference, where he was going to announce the weather satellite, Tyros took a picture of a hurricane. The first hurricane in world history to be photographed from outer space. All of a sudden, we knew its size, its magnitude, its direction. We could predict more or less where it was going to hit landfall. Millions of dollars in property damage could be avoided. Hundreds, thousands of people didn't have to die. And I still remember watching it on the TV. I still remember LBJ came on the television that night and said, tonight, the space program has paid for itself. I would even say that's wrong. I would say the space program has paid for itself many times over again. Save thousands of lives, save millions of dollars, and it does that every day. We now detect typhoons and hurricanes all over the world for free.